Welcome to the lecture series of Differential Calculus. Today we are going to see a problem under Yawlut. Look at the question. Find the Yawlut of the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Considering the Yawlut of curve as the envelope of its normal. So the question comes under like this. That is, we have to find out the Yawlut. That is nothing but envelope of the normal equation. So what we have to do is, we have to write the normal equation of the given curve. For that normal equation, we have to find out the envelope. That is what the problem. So now we'll take any point on the curve, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. So the solution, any point on the curve, any point on the given curve, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 is a cos theta, comma b sin theta, and this point is nothing but the parametric equation, okay, on the ellipse. Now the normal equation at the point is the normal equation at the point is x comma y. X means a cos theta, y is b sin theta. So the normal equation is ax by cos theta minus by sin theta equal to a square minus b square equal to 1. So this is the normal equation for the ellipse. What is the equation? Ax by cos theta minus by by sin theta equal to a square minus b square. We call this as equation 1. So for this normal equation, we have to find out the envelope. For finding the envelope, two methods are there. One is finding a quadratic equation with the parameter, or we have to differentiate with respect to the parameter. So now we are going to do the method 2. So here the parameter is theta. So the given equation, that is the normal equation, we can write this as ax into cos theta power minus 1 minus by into sin theta power minus 1 equal to a square minus b square. Now we are going to differentiate with respect to theta. So what will happen? Ax into this minus 1 cos theta power minus 2, differentiation of cos is minus sin theta, minus by into minus 1 sin theta power minus 2, differentiation of sin is cos theta equal to 0, because a square minus b square is a constant. So this can be written as minus into minus plus. So we can write this as ax sin theta divided by cos square theta, and here also minus into minus plus by cos theta divided by sin square theta equal to 0. Okay, so the now the equation, normal equation, has reduced like this, and now this can be written as ax sin theta divided by cos square theta equal to minus by cos theta by sin square theta, which implies ax by cos cube theta equal to minus by by sin cube theta. From this we can write sin cube theta by cos cube theta equal to minus by by ax. Sin by cos is nothing but tan. So this implies tan cube theta equal to minus by by ax. So which implies tan theta equal to minus by power 1 by 3 by ax power 1 by 3. Now from the tan theta, we can write sin theta equal to plus or minus by power 1 by 3 divided by root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3. By the same manner, we can write the cos theta. Cos theta equal to plus or minus ax power 1 by 3 divided by root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3. How we are writing from the tan theta like this? Okay, Actually, we got the tan theta answer as like this. From this only, we are writing the sin theta and cos theta. How we are writing this means we have to consider the Pythagoras theorem. Look at this diagram. From this diagram only, we are writing that. If I am taking this as 90 degree, so ax power 1 by 3. From the value of sin and cos, we are writing these two sides. So obviously, the value of hypotenuse is nothing but root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 if I am taking the angle theta. Okay, so from this sin theta equal to and cos theta equal to, that is the reason because of this diagram we are writing like this, or otherwise directly from the tan theta also we can write this one. So now we got the answer for sin theta and cos theta. We'll back to our equation 1. What is our equation 1? Ax by cos theta minus by by sin theta equal to a square minus b square. So in this equation we are going to substitute the value of cos theta and sin theta. Therefore from equation 1, ax by cos theta, that means a cos theta value is this one. So from this one, 1 by cos theta, that means what? Root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 divided by ax power 1 by 3. Okay, ax by cos theta minus by by sin theta, that means what? Root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 divided by by power equal to a square minus b square. Now in these two terms we can take this root of a. So we can commonly take root of ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 commonly outside. So write the remaining. What is the remaining here? Remaining is ax power, there is 1 and the denominator 1 by 3. So 1 minus 1 by 3 minus by power 1 minus 1 by 3 equal to a square minus b square. Okay, so now this can be written as actually ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 square root means what? Power is 1 by 2 and here it is 3 minus 2, that means 2 by 3. So this is equal to ax power 2 by 3 minus by power 2 by 3 into, okay, so which is equal to a square minus b square. Now here we are getting plus and here it is minus, so we can write this as ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 whole power 1 by 2 into ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 equal to a square minus b square. Why we are writing like this means you can take this minus into the by. So minus by power 2 by 3. We have discussed already like this type of question. So this can be written as minus by square whole power 1 by 3. So automatically this will become as by power 2 by 3. So instead of minus we can write plus. So now here it is, what is the power? Ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 whole power 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay, 1 by 2 plus 1 equal to a square minus b square. So which implies ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3 whole power 2 plus 1, 3. So whole power 3 by 2 equal to a square minus b square. Now we have raised to the power 2 by 3 on both sides. So raised to the power 2 by 3 on both sides. So what will happen? Which implies ax power 2 by 3 plus by power 2 by 3. When you are raising the power 2 by 3, this 3 by 2 will be cancelled off, which is equal to a square minus b square whole power 2 by 3. So this is nothing but this is the required equation of Yavalud and the envelope of normal. So this is the answer for the given question. Thank you for watching.